In part 6 of our lesson on polar equations and graphs, you will learn how to find an equivalent equation for a line in rectangular coordinates. Let's do a quick algebra review here. We know that in rectangular coordinates, the standard equation of a line is ax plus by is equal to c. Now, if we want to solve for the y-intercept in that equation, we know that we would set x equal to 0 and then solve for y. And then that would give us the y-intercept. Similarly, to solve for the x-intercept, we would set y equals 0 and solve for x. You have also studied the slope-intercept equation of a line, which looks like y equals mx plus b, where the coefficient of the x term, m, is equal to the slope of the line, and the point 0 comma b is the y-intercept. So let's see how these equations can help us make a polar equation graph. In this example, we have to find an equivalent equation in rectangular coordinates and sketch the graph of r equals 12 over 3 cosine theta minus 4 sine theta. Now, this would be a very challenging graph to make in polar coordinates because we would be plugging in theta here for cosine theta and then take it times 3, plug in theta here and get sine theta, take it times 4, then we have to subtract those two, and then we have to take 12 and divide by that number. And we would have to do that for every point going around from 0 to 2 pi. That would be a lot of work. Now, it turns out that we can try finding an equivalent equation in rectangular coordinates and see if that might simplify our graphing at all. Now, remember that our conversion factors are that x is equal to r cosine theta and y is equal to r sine of theta. Now, we don't have r cosine of theta in our equation. We only have 3 cosine theta. We don't have r sine theta. We have 4 sine theta. We would need an r in both of these terms, and they don't have an r. Now, one of the things we could do, though, is we notice we have an r over here on the left-hand side of the equation. So we can go ahead, take this denominator, and cross-multiply it up to the left-hand side. So we would get r times the quantity 3 cosine theta minus 4 sine theta is equal to 12. Distributing the r, we get 3r cosine theta minus 4r sine theta is equal to 12. Now we see that we can make these substitutions because the r cosine of theta is going to get substituted for x. And the r sine of theta can get substituted for y. So our equation becomes 3x minus 4y is equal to 12. And you notice, looking at your algebra review, that this is the standard equation for a line. One of the easiest ways to graph a line when it is in standard form is to find the x and y intercepts. So if we set x equal to 0, we know our equation becomes 3 times 0 minus 4y is equal to 12. Of course, 3 times 0 is 0, so that cancels out. If we divide both sides by negative 4, we get y is equal to negative 3. So that tells us that our y-intercept will be the point 0, negative 3, and this is in rectangular coordinates. We can plug in y is equal to 0, and we get 3x minus 4 times 0 is equal to 12. Of course, the 0 here wipes that term out. Dividing both sides by 3, we get that x is equal to 4, so our x-intercept is going to be the point 4, 0, and again, that is in rectangular coordinates. Now, to graph this line, what you will want to visualize is seeing the rectangular coordinate plane superimposed on the polar coordinate plane. Now, all we have to do to graph a line is plot 2 points. We have 2 points. We know that the y-intercept will be at 0, negative 3. So right here. We know that the x-intercept is at 4, 0. So that will be right here. And now all we have to do is connect those 2 points. So there is the graph of our polar equation, which started out as r equals 12 over 3 cosine theta minus 4 sine theta. Now that would have been very challenging to graph using the polar equation, but by converting it into a rectangular equation, it got so much simpler, we realized that it was just the standard equation for a line, which meant once we found the x and y intercept and plotted those 2 points, we would very quickly get to the graph of the equation. So sometimes converting from polar coordinates to rectangular coordinates can make your graphing go much, much faster.